This very rare total eclipse will make its way across the United States about 10 days from this recording on April 8th, 2024, which also happens to be the year of the dragon. Will anything happen on April 8th, the day of the total eclipse? Well, yes and no. Not in the sense that there will be destruction, chaos, the end of the world, people expecting a Y2K 2012 style event. That is not going to happen. But something will happen along the lines of a ritual, a great summoning, trying to usher something in or perhaps awaken something. Now, if you are on the fence about something bizarre or eerie happening on April 8th, well, maybe CERN will change your mind. The same CERN that starts up what is known as a proton accelerator, the Large Hadron Collider, which many people believe is the reason why the world happens to be so weird. People also blame CERN and the Large Hadron Collider for things like the Mandela effect. Why is Pikachu's tail not black? Why is it the Berenstain Bears and not the Berenstein Bears? Why does Fruit of the Loom no longer have a cornucopia? People say that today's world is just so evil, so dark, so different, so strange, so weird. Can we please go back to Universe A, where we came from? The universe where McDonald's look like this and not this. Well, hold your horses, because CERN is getting ready to shift us into another reality. CERN will test the world's most powerful particle accelerator during April's solar eclipse to search for invisible matter that secretly powers our universe. The Large Hadron Collider will smash atoms together for the first time since 2022. The experiment hopes to discover subatomic particles that exist inside atoms. Now, these people at CERN are not looking for just any type of matter. They are specifically looking for dark matter during the total eclipse. As this devil's comet passes by the sun, these people at CERN will fire up the Large Hadron Collider to look for dark matter. CERN will shoot down billions of protons down a 17-mile-long tunnel at nearly the speed of light to recreate conditions a second after the Big Bang. This second after this Big Bang is probably where these rifts, these portals open up and these entities come through. Or just perhaps new realities merge. Alternate realities cross over. Perhaps this time fish will identify as dogs. You never know. You'll look up and you'll say to the person next to you, "Hey, look at those birds." And that person next to you will say, "No, that's not a bird, that's a cat. What are you talking about?" And you'll say, "Oh, okay, I thought they used to be called birds." "No, no, what are you talking about? Oh, that must be a Mandela effect." Mandela? Why are you talking about the 45th president of the United States? So who knows what's going to happen? Who knows what's going to change when conditions are created a second after the Big Bang? During this ultra-rare total eclipse that will form this black X over the United States as this devil's comet is seen at the same time. Now, the LHC will continue the experiment until later this year, when it will then be put under a long hibernation for CERN to transform it into the next version, the High Luminosity LHC. Now, the team that's on the hunt for this dark matter, they state, which makes up around 28% of our massive universe, but it hasn't been seen or proven, but it makes up 28% of the massive universe. They continue to state that this work will give them insights into the formation of the universe and even its ultimate fate. The experiment is scheduled to occur the same day as the Great North American Solar Eclipse. Now, why are they turning on the LHC during the total eclipse? We don't know. They don't give a reason. Will this help them find the dark matter particles? They don't say so. They say they will be performing this hunt at later dates, so I guess the solar eclipse has nothing to do with them finding this dark matter. It's just a coincidence, a quote-unquote coincidence, that they will turn on the LHC the same day as this total eclipse. This does get a little freakier when you go to the CERN website. Have you ever taken a look at the CERN logo? Doesn't it look like 666? But anyway, when you read this paragraph here, the Large Hadron Collider will go through a few phases. The injector chain has an ambitious year ahead as well. The injectors have a busy fixed target program and will provide beams to all the experimental facilities. Physics in Isolde, downstream of the PS booster, will start on April 8th, the same day as the total eclipse, followed by the SPS North Area on the 10th of April. The antimatter factory is set to start delivering antiprotons to its experiments on April 22nd. The awake facility behind the SPS will run for 10 weeks in total, in blocks of two or three until the middle of September. So this will all just end with a awake facility. Isn't that just creepy? But what am I creeped out for? This is just a name. Nothing will cross over. Nothing will be summoned over through a portal and have to be awoken. No, the awake facility is just a name of the facility where everything will finalize. There's nothing to be worried about anyway. Our brave fact checkers have told us they looked into it and found out that the scientists at CERN are definitely not opening a portal to hell. Well, thank you, fact checkers. I hope to one day be as big and strong as you when I grow up. This is why I eat all my Cocoa Puffs and drink all my milk. But I do want to hear from you. Please do comment in the comment section below. Are you a little bit more nervous about this total eclipse now that CERN is involved? Or does it not change your mind whatsoever? In any case, please do comment in the comment section below. Thank you so much for watching. If you like this channel and you want to see more, please subscribe. If you're already subscribed, please like, as any engagement does help the channel grow. Once again, thank you so much for your support.